The book, The Art of Raising Capital, is dedicated to every entrepreneur who has been turned down by a bank and is reaching out to private investors to fund his venture. To access money is one of the biggest challenges entrepreneurs face. Whether they are looking to start a small business or build an international empire, the success of their business is directly tied to having enough capital to keep growing. There is both an art and a science to raising capital, and the author, Darren Weeks, speaks to both of them from the lenses of his own experience as a professional real estate investor. At RNG, we review the books you want to read and present them to you in a short and memorable video. Make this channel part of your daily routine and check our book summaries for timeless principles, new insights, and unwavering motivation. Please subscribe and turn on the notification bell in order to stay tuned. One thing capital cannot do is turn a failing business into a strong one. If your business is flawed and the profits are just not there, then all capital can do is allow you to continue operating longer than you could have without it. Ask yourself if lack of capital is the only thing holding your business back. If you have a clear plan to become profitable and a strong team to do it, this is the book that will help you raise the capital you need. Starting out. The most important thing to investors, especially the ones that invest capital into private partnerships and joint ventures, is not the return you promise, but whether or not they can trust you to deliver on what you say. Selling people on you requires an investment of time and money into maintaining a professional appearance. Developing basic marketing materials like business cards and a website. Mastering the content of your business and the world of finance. Your knowledge puts investors at ease. People don't invest in your business deal, they invest in you. You need to sell them on your story. A good story outlines the business plan and the process and introduces the team. Your team can become a selling point because of the years of experience it adds to your own. Turn your story into a 30-second commercial that you can use when you are networking. This is not your deal pitch. This is a quick summary of what you can do for a specific type of person. The value of the commercial is that it filters people and helps you catch the right person's interest and open the way to further discussion. Building your capital network. As an entrepreneur, your life will be much easier when you can build your business by leveraging other people's money and other people's efforts. This is impossible to do without a network. Your network needs to be built with intention and patience. Unlike sales, networking isn't about waiting through no's until you get a yes. Quality network involves connecting with people and learning about their needs and goals. If you do this enough times, you will start to create a database of potential investors. To build your database, go to trade shows, conventions, entrepreneur organizations. Your goal there is to get contact information of people who are interested and then follow up shortly. Another way to build a powerful network is to find an entrepreneur that you respect and who is much more successful than you, and work for them for free. This is going to give you vital experience and also expose you to excellent people who may be future prospects or even team members someday. They can also refer people to you who might find your services useful. The first meeting. Once you've made contact with a potential investor on a networking event or some other source, it's time to follow up and set the first meeting. In order for follow-up to be effective, you need to have some contact with a prospect within a week of meeting him. Your first meeting can be considered a success if you have been able to learn about the investor's current investments, the return he expects, and whether or not he is worth continuing meeting with him. You are probably not getting a commitment to invest right away. Use an upfront contract and template with your questions to ensure that the meeting achieves its purpose. The upfront contract sets the ground rules for the meeting, commits to a timeline, and outlines the decisions that are required by the end of the meeting. The purpose of a specific question strategy is to draw out important information without wasting time. You want to minimize the time you spend chasing unlikely leads, so you have to filter down to people who have the money to invest and can benefit from the deal you are offering. Your story. At this stage, you know the person on the other side and have an idea how he analyzes investments. You have also given him a brief overview of the opportunity through your 30-second commercial and the marketing material you have sent to him. It's time to present your story in full, tailoring it to the person in front of you. Keep in mind that success in raising capital is 95% you and your story, and 5% the actual deal. When presenting your story to investors, it's important to start from the big picture and work your way down. Only a small percentage of people have ever put money into a joint venture or a private investment, so you need to take them to the idea gently. Now that you have built rapport with your potential investor during your first meeting, he is ready to listen to you with an open mind. Help him grow his context and educate him on the pros and cons of the different investment classes. Then move on to your story. The BI triangle from Rich Dad's Guide to Investing is a great framework you can use to present your story. Talk to your investor about each of the pillars of the triangle, and do start with your mission. By the end of the presentation, you want to know whether the investor intends to invest or not, and when. Consider a maybe as a no. Group presentations. The most obvious way to leverage your time when raising capital is to present your story to a large group of people. Group presentations involve very different dynamics from meetings with investors face-to-face. The most obvious one being that you don't have the same type of information on each person and have not built rapport with each one of them. A few tips that will increase your success rate are: offer something up front, like a meal, to increase attendance at your presentation. Present the same content, but with a lot more passion and confidence. Practice, practice, practice. Peripherals like slideshows and props should enhance your presentation, not drive it. Engage the crowd whenever possible. Close the presentation by setting up a way to follow up and discuss the investment. Structuring a deal. When structuring a deal, there are two things you have to keep in mind. You want to be transparent with your investor and compliant with the laws in your region. Get a good lawyer to find the right way to paper the deal and be responsible for compliance. You are responsible for transparency. Be absolutely honest with your investor. If you try to make money on the side from the deal, you will quickly find yourself out of business. On the flip side, the more deals you do successfully and handle with integrity, the more investors will seek you out to do business with you. Some of them might even end up being your business partners. Keep your investors happy. You have found an investor and have an agreement on paper. Hard part is over, right? Wrong. Now comes the hard work to keep investors happy with their investment. When everything is right and you deliver the financial returns you promised, that part is easy. But you should do the extra mile to create a positive experience, which can help cushion the impact when things go less than perfect. How to create a positive experience. A regular communication with the investors makes them feel they are being valued. Have a monthly newsletter to cover the personal angle and quarterly updates reporting on the performance of the investment. If there is a problem, set a meeting with the investors to discuss it. Evaluate the seriousness of the situation. Look for the cause. Decide on a corrective action. If the problem is external, go back to the plan and see if it still makes sense. Be transparent. In the case of absolute failure, you must continue to communicate openly and honestly with your investors. If you can personally face them and tell them what went wrong, you are reinforcing their trust in you as a professional, even though you can't deliver on the results you promised. If you are serious about raising capital for your business, The Art of Raising Capital is a must read. The book is full of great advice and creative ideas on how to make the journey successful and enjoyable. It is also endorsed by Robert Kiyosaki, who wrote the foreword to it. If you enjoyed this video, you are sure to like our summary of Midas Touch by Trump and Kiyosaki, another great book for entrepreneurs. Thank you for watching. Please check out our channel for more videos like this. Tell us in the comments, what is your favorite book? Can't get enough of reading? Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/readandgrow1 and also on Twitter at twitter.com/readandgrow1.